on walking, ain't no stopping in this dirty, filthy, rotten, nasty little world we call a home. They get Mickey's popping.
Okay. So, trying something new, different. So basically, I made an intro video without planning what the rest of my content was gonna look like, and then somehow fell into a really weird YouTube hole of like, my entire feed right now is like, I don't know, if you're a creative, especially like a self-taught creative in many mediums, like you definitely understand that like, there's so many videos out there geared towards leveling up, learning the next medium that's gonna, you know, how to learn Blender in 30 days or how to learn Blender in a week, how to make your video shots the most amazing, crispy, cinematic, like everything is about leveling up your creative output, at least in my feed. It's put me in this weird state of just like doing nothing because I feel like everything that I already know how to do is not shit, basically. And it's just kind of like, fuck. Like, long story short, for most of us creatives, you grow up from a very young age, you know, doing the things that you love. I remember getting little packs of polymer clay, like in middle school, and bringing them home to make different types of charms and, you know, pizzas and chocolate bars and all this other stuff. If I can find pictures, I'll include some of the stuff that I made when I was younger. But the point being is that, one, that was part of my super close connection to YouTube, and two, that was when I first started having creative outputs. I mean, you can count like drawings as a kid, and I might even have like pictures of like some things I sculpted when I was in art school and, or in school in art class. But yeah, like I was making creative outputs with no external, you know, pressures. You know, there was 20 and 30 something year old, you know, sculptors who were on YouTube making the miniature tutorials, but it was always like, here's this thing that I love so much and I want to share it with you all, and if you make it, post pictures. And now it's like, how to get the smoothest or greatest, most realistic. Everything is so like, it's no longer okay to just do something just to do it. You have to do it to be great. I felt immobilized until I remembered that, like, I'm not doing this for a paycheck. I'm not doing this to make money off of YouTube. Like I said in my reintroduction video, I'm doing it to make my community, to meet my community. Because I think it's lonely. I haven't thought about whether I want to use that word on the internet in front of white people, so excuse me. But anyway. Things like that, you know, not wanting to edit out those parts of myself because that's exactly where my community will find me, right? So, the other thing about it is I'm going to go on my first solo trip ever in less than 1 week. And I'm going to LA. I'm going to be in downtown LA. I've done my research. I've literally spent the last month literally on Reddit, on YouTube, which is semi-helpful for that topic, and just anywhere and everywhere that I can find information. I've been looking at public transit, I've been looking at, you know, places to stay in the housing market, in Airbnb, in hotels, what people think about that, the gas prices, the traffic, the food, whether it's good or it's not, or it's expensive, it's vegan, it's blah, 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 blah. I have inundated myself with information about LA, and I still don't know shit, but I've been playing with this idea of like what content there is on YouTube about LA or people moving to LA or leaving. It's all very one note and on the surface, and everyone just regurgitating the same information that everybody else is saying, and everybody is like a like soft life luxury black girl that I've been seeing, and like sometimes Christian, like no shade, but like, girl, half the furniture in here came from Goodwill, a lot of my, like, I'm a bartender and I have like fancy dish or glass sets and stuff. Those came from Goodwill. Like, most of my clothes came from the fucking bins. And so I've been thinking, like, do people want to see, like, basically, like, a broke but also entrepreneur real artist taking on LA? Also, like, what if I fail? Like, I don't know if I want to document that. Because, like, I have all of these people that I feel like in the city I'm leaving. I can't say that I think they're watching, but I know that there are people that might not expect me to succeed. And honestly, I think it's a minority. Like, for the most part, people have been so supportive. But, like, there's just this nagging feeling in the back of my head of, like, I want to document this. I want to share myself, my personality, my perspectives on the internet and make an impact. By being everything that I don't see on the platform and being myself. But then I'm like scared to share that journey with people who already know me. Well, who already don't know me. They think they know me. But point being is I know I have an interesting perspective to bring to it. But then there's also the context of like, how do Angelenos feel about people coming into their home and putting their opinion on a public social platform, which innately that behavior is pedestalizing or making important my thoughts, views, and opinions. And that's another thing that I see very prominent in YouTube culture at this point of like people making content that is not at all critically aware of what their behavior says or what it means. Like, I've been on the platform a bit recently. Who am I kidding? I'm on YouTube every fucking day. But I recently came across this subgenre of video of like, buy the cheapest flight every day and see where I end up. So it's basically these European white men traveling around the continent, because when you go on Skyscanner, you can find flights that are literally like $5-$10 to go to a whole other country. The one thing I thought about was like, interesting, I don't see any women taking in this genre. Like, it's kind of giving colonizer, for one. And for two, like, again, this is a genre that I'm sure it's like super easy to get views. For one part of it, like, they literally were flying to a different place every day. And like, or that's like the whole thing. But it's like, you're literally like abusing your body, like doing all this stuff. And like, for some people, like for content, for some people, you know, that lifestyle might be something you would do regardless. But it's like, there was even a little joke in the one video where he's like, his friend is joking about him like dying alone or something like that, and he's like, yeah, knowing this line of work, probably. And I'm like, just like the level of like, I don't know, I have other things to talk about, so I'll leave that there. But again, there's these little different pockets of things that I'm picking up on the platform, and all of it is just making me feel like pushed further and further away from wanting to create. And so here I am talking about it, because at first I got a little bit nervous because I was like, oh God, like I could talk about like what it's like to move across country, or like thinking about the heavy hitting like title structures that people use and how I can fit content into that. But then it's like, literally, I released a video like a week or two ago, and in that short amount of time, I already forgot my purpose for creating content because I was so busy consuming content that is for the algorithm. And then I also had to think about, like, is it okay for me if nobody watches my shit? If I'm 10 videos deep and I still have, like, 56 people watching each video, am I going to be okay with that? And the reality of it is that if this platform ever becomes something that prioritizes the business of YouTube before showcasing me and who I am, I think that is when a timeline or a clock has started for when it's no longer fun. And so even if it takes me a month in between videos to post, I'm gonna do that because I wanna wait until inspiration strikes. I don't wanna fall into the YouTube rabbit hole of producing content. Fuck content. This is my life. I wanna say what I wanna say and I'm gonna do what I wanna do. And so with that being said, I would like to make content that documents my life. And right now the biggest thing going on in my life is the fact that I'm fucking moving across the country. Ah! Anyway. So yes. The next video that I would like to make is the first solo travel experience, going to LA. And I don't know, I'm really scared. One, I'm not a vlogger girly. Not a girly at all. But, non-binary, they, anyway. I'm already weirded out by the idea of vlogging in Pittsburgh. So I can't imagine being around so many more people and being comfortable just like, hey guys. But anyway, I might do it. I might. Because, well, what's going to happen is I'm going to capture video documentation of my trip in the best way that I can possible. How I document myself, I don't know. The way all these fucking LA content creators leave their cameras places to get videos of them, y'all are bold and brave. I barely want to take my shit out and I've never been there before. But anyway, I'll be going to LA from, do I want to say the dates? Next week, Tuesday until Sunday. And yeah, I'm going to, my main purpose is to try and find like a little community situation. And so I'll be going to a Cuties of Light co-working event just to like catch a vibe for, you know, if I'm bored in my house on a Wednesday and I feel like getting some work done with other queer cuties around, what's the vibe? I'm trying to get to Moonlight Roller Skate Wave for their LGBTQ night. But then I also have to get back down to downtown LA for the precinct because my friend is going to be performing on Valentine's Day and I'm fucking excited. And then, honestly, it's probably going to be the best Valentine's Day of my life. So that's all I have to say about that. What else? I also want to go to the Queer Mercado, which is happening at the end of the week, and support some artists local to LA, also queer artists. And I believe it's all like Latino artists, so that'll be amazing. I've literally never experienced anything like that in my life because I grew up in Pennsylvania. Boring. Oh, I want to go to WeSpa. I might already be too late, but I should probably book that so I can do it. There is this app called Too Good To Go, which is basically like a food waste intervention. And so I've tried to use it in certain cities before, but like LA seems like the type of place that would use it. And so that's also a possible content idea. I found this one person's channel of a videographer who does this like thing where he goes and walks around New York City and finds a music artist to like make them famous by making them a music video. And so I watched it, and literally 5 minutes into the video, they're making a racist joke against East Asian people. And it's like, and so, if nothing else, I feel motivated to make content because I'm tired of seeing stuff like that. I'm tired of watching content from people who don't share the same values as me. I'm allowing these people so much time, space, and energy in my fucking head just so I don't have to be bored. No. No. But yeah. So those are my thoughts. I'll be going to LA next week. try and document as much. I will be trying to document what I feel drawn to document.